Scovia Dawa and her family arrived in Yumbe district in March 2016 after they escaped the war in South Sudan. The mother of six says before they were settled, they had fewer challenges.
Actually, they used to feed us very well. But the challenges, we started feeling them when we have already started settling.
But following the influx of refugees from South Sudan and neighboring Democratic Republic of Congo, the feeding pattern was revised to cereal rations, which Scovia says are not sufficient.
The ration they are giving to us, they are serving to us, is not enough. They can share for the ration for some size 7. They were told you to use that ration for 1 man. And the ration they are giving you cannot reach 1 man.
The funding that we receive in this operation is a little bit very low. For example, for this year, we have managed to get only 40% of the 100% required funding. So this also affects the contributes to the fact that instead of posho or flour, we give grain. It is because of funding constraints.
As a result, some of the refugees have resorted to selling part of their rations to start up small businesses.
You get a 5 liters of cooking oil. You go and sell. After selling that cooking oil, you go and buy the other things so that you started selling them.
One thing that we strongly discourage, but reality is they have to live. They have other items that they need to survive, for example, clothes, undies. Sometimes we fail to get funding to buy things like sanitary pads, and we take like quite a longer period.
Despite the prevailing conditions, Scovia says if herself and other women in the camp were given startup capital, they could be able to provide the much needed home essentials.
We can manage ourselves with their small capital. Because small thing you get in, you can buy a sugar there for your kids, you can get also a balanced diet there for your kids.
Uganda has received immense support from partners towards managing the influx of refugees over the last few years. However, Uganda's refugee response remains chronically underfunded.
Only 43% of the required resources have been met. Only 43%. So I want to use this opportunity, and tomorrow again as we wrap up, to request our partners to really rise up to this burden sharing. Because while we are happy to host, it is the responsibility of the international community to support our effort in taking care of sharing this burden.
Despite the signed peace accord between South Sudan's President Salva Kiir and his rival Riek Machar, refugees continue to cross into Uganda because there is still fighting in many areas.
We still receive about 60 people coming from Sudan every morning despite the peace accord. On the other side of DR Congo, I'm told about 30 every morning. It is mainly mothers, women and children. So that suggests that there are still some tremors in some parts of the country while the capital cities might be peaceful.
The creation of the Comprehensive Refugee Response Framework under the Office of the Prime Minister has bridged the gaps in service delivery.
We used to assume that we know all about what refugees need. Now with the new arrangement, we consult the refugees. They're also part of our CRRF, particularly steering group, and even some informed the secretariat. So the refugees are there, the NGOs are there, the UN is there, the government is there, so everybody is there. So that's the difference. Long ago, we would just take a decision in Kampala and come and implement. Now we don't.
For now, the Bidibidi settlement is still receiving refugees, and it's still not clear how long it will take before South Sudan is stable enough for them to go back home. Aaron Mukama, NTV, Bidibidi Camp in Yumbe District.